One of the most important thing during your PhD is your relationship with your PhD supervisor. In this video, I'm going to highlight 5 key mistakes which students mostly do while communicating with their PhD supervisor. So let's get started. Hello, my name is Tahir Yaqub, and if this is your first time, please hit the subscribe button and also the notification bell to get notified whenever I post a brand new YouTube video on this channel on every Tuesday and Friday. So the first thing is, never say anything disrespectful to your PhD supervisor. This looks very straightforward, and mostly this mistake happens unintentionally. I am making this video in Australia, and Australia is a multicultural society, and there is a multicultural aspect which I want to highlight here. So let's say you are doing PhD in Australia and you are not a native English speaker. So when you try to communicate with your supervisor in an email or direct communication, the selection of words is very important. So in particular, when you are writing an email, so text cannot communicate the correct tone if you are not paying attention. So if you are good at communication and you pay attention while writing email, that is fine. And most probably you will not do this mistake. And the second thing is, there are some cultural issues. For example, sir is a word of respect all around the globe. But in Australia, Australians prefer to call with the first name. So if you call your supervisor sir, it might look a bit stiff. But if you call it again and again, so he might feel uncomfortable while talking to you. I'm not saying that sir is a word of disrespect. I'm just saying that you should understand the culture. And the point is that you cannot assume that the people you are encountering, they share your core values. Now, the second point is, you should never say it cannot be done. This is wrong for many reasons. First of all, this statement is applicable to 2 different situations. One is that this cannot be done within a time frame. The second is that this cannot be done in an absolute sense. You should not say this in any of these situations, because in PhD, there are deadlines. You have to face those deadlines and you have to meet those deadlines. You cannot say this cannot be done, because PhD is not a self-paced program. And the people who believe it is a self-paced program, they become more and more passive, more and more lazy as the time goes by, and they never finish their PhD. So supervisor would be worried about you if you say this cannot be done. And the second thing is that, for example, a supervisor says that you complete this task by that time and you cannot finish it. You know that you won't be able to finish it. So what you should do is, you should think in your mind that I would be able to finish at least 80% of this task. So you should say to your supervisor, I'm confident that I will finish 80%. So this is not a yes. This is not a no, but this is a good statement. Now, let's take another example. Let us say that your supervisor asks you to try a new experiment and you say, no, it cannot be done. You are not in a position to say that, because you have not tried, you have not tested. So how can you say that this cannot be done? And the second important thing is, this will not preserve your feeling of competence. We want to preserve your feeling of competence. You should feel competent about you, that you can do. Your can-do attitude is very good. And we also want your supervisor to believe in you, that you can do this. So this is also wrong in many ways, that it cannot be done. Now, the third important thing is that you should never, ever tell your supervisor about your personal matters, about your family problems, about your problems with your partner, about your financial issues. Because telling someone about your personal problems is always considered as a weakness. You should realize that your relationship with your supervisor is purely professional. At the very least, what the supervisor will do is that he or she will never recommend you for any opportunity, because he or she will think that you are emotionally a weak person. So this is not a good thing. Now, the fourth important thing is, a situation can come when your supervisor asks you about something. Do you know this? For example, I give you a control engineering example, that if your supervisor asks you, do you know MATLAB? MATLAB is a common software. And you would think in your mind, if you say no, what the supervisor will think about you, that this guy doesn't know even this very common software. This approach you feel in your mind, and then you say, yes, I know this, while actually you don't know that. So this is absolutely wrong, and this problem can lead to a very complex problems later on. This looks very simple, but it is not. There are few things, few issues in related to this. The first issue is that your supervisor will now expect that you know MATLAB, and he might ask you to do something, and now you have to learn first and then do that, and you won't be able to deliver within a specific time which is in the mind of your supervisor. And now he will become passive because he will think that you are not very passionate about your PhD. So this is the least important thing, that you will not fulfill his or her expectations. The most important thing is, if you say something like that, you will lose the honesty. Truth and honesty does matter in any relationship. No, actually, you lied to your supervisor, and it will shake your integrity, because eventually he or she will know that you don't know MATLAB. You don't know this thing, whatever the thing is. So therefore, be honest, be straightforward, upfront, what you know or what you don't know, you can tell your supervisor. For example, I don't know MATLAB because I work in Scilab, which is a very close software to MATLAB, and you can do almost everything in Scilab, which is an open source software. So say something like that. Now the last thing, the first thing when you start your PhD, the supervisor most probably will give you a paper to read or something to read. And then you start reading, and then you read one paper, two papers, 10 papers, and you don't understand. And you don't understand, and you don't tell your supervisor that you don't understand anything of these papers. A stage will come when you will get frustrated. And now when your supervisor says to you, read this thing, you would say, reading is not very helpful, and reading is useless. I couldn't get anything out of this reading. Now, this is probably the most serious thing you will ever say to your supervisor. Listen, guys, PhD is all about reading. And if you become allergic to reading at some point, and you express this to your supervisor, then you should not be doing your PhD, full stop. Because PhD is all about reading. Reading is the blood and oxygen of your PhD. And you should read, you should be willing to read. In one of my previous videos, I explained the importance of reading, that if you are trying to publish your paper in a journal, you must read, read, read. A stage will come when you will feel that you are now ready to publish in that journal. So I will put a link here of that video, so you can watch that video. So this is the most important thing you should avoid saying to your supervisor, because this is one of the key things about the students who never finish their PhD. Supervisor give them something to read and they come back without reading. So the good thing to do at this point is, if a supervisor gives you something to read, you read it. Whatever you understand, you make notes, and then notes means that you make notes on your diary, and then when you go back into the next meeting, you explain to your supervisor whatever you understood out of that paper. That is the best approach. He will feel the motivation, he will feel your passion, although you didn't understand that correctly, but that is one of the best things you can ever do to impress your supervisor. To read something, to make notes, and to discuss with your supervisor what you understand. So I hope that you will take care of about these few mistakes, and you will be careful what to say, what not to say. And I would like to see your comments. So please comment in this video if you have any question. I answer all the questions on my videos. So if you have any question or any comment, please put in the description. And if you like this video, please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel, because that will help me to grow my channel so that I could make more videos of this kind. Thanks for watching. See you next time.